All right, well, the second highest ranking administrator in the U.S. Department of Agriculture is touring the islands this week, and we are honored to have USDA Deputy Secretary Krista Hardin in studio, as well as Senator Mazie Hirono. Thank
you
guys so much for joining us.
And congratulations on your new position here.
Thank you very much. I appreciate that. Sure. Krista, let's begin with you. You traveled to Hawaii to get a first-hand look at some of the unique agricultural issues that we are facing out here as a state. What have you observed?
Well, it's interesting. The senator talks to me all the time back in Washington about the uniqueness and some of the challenges, but also the opportunities for Hawaii farmers. So I want to come out and just say firsthand, I mean, you can read briefings, you can have conversations, but you don't realize some of the real challenges that farmers have here. So I've had a good lesson so far, and more to come.
Yeah, where have you guys gone so far? On, I know it's a lot of stuff, and you're covering a lot of acreage in a lot of days, but where have you guys gone? What's in the cards?
Well, we were on the east side of the island of Hawaii yesterday.
Hilo.
Hilo, mm-hmm. Yes, thank you, in that area, and talked to flower producers, just gorgeous, wonderful orchids and some of their challenges. We're going to go see coffee producers tomorrow, so mm-hmm. we're trying to see as much as we can in a very short time.
Yeah, and of course, staying with you, Krista, real quick, the coffee borer beetle, that's obviously
yes.
something that's very impacting much of our state right now. There's been a lot of talk about, you know, needing stricter quarantine guidelines, but again, I know you've only been here for just a bit, but do you think that those kind of guidelines will help keep these pests out? I mean, either one of you can actually take this question.
Well, the deputy secretary got an earful yesterday about how vulnerable we are to invasive species, and of course, the coffee berry borer beetle. That is a mouthful. Came in some fashion, and it's really impacting negatively our coffee industry. And so, I do want to thank our secretary for being here, because for her to come here and spend 2.5 days, 3 days, just to get a firsthand look at the challenges we're facing. USDA presence in Hawaii is really quite extensive, because they help with research, such as I noticed that you're showing mm-hmm. coffee, research on pests. They help with our rural communities with infrastructure needs. They're involved with our school lunch program, which mm-hmm. we're going to go to today. So, you know, they're really extensively involved here, and it's great that she is here to learn firsthand the impact and the importance of USDA in Hawaii.
Yeah, Krista, what type of impacts can we get? What kind of benefits can we get in Hawaii for the agriculture industry and all that type of stuff?
Well, it's a lot of investment in research here, yeah. and we continue to look for solutions to some of the problems that the senator just outlined, but also just opportunities for farmers, just markets for them, looking for everything we can to help them. We want farmers to stay on the farm, and we want young people to come back to farms as well. We're going to be talking about that a bit in the next day or so as well.
Yeah, you know, staying on that note, Senator, there's a lot of talk in Hawaii about keeping itself sustained,
sure.
you know.
Food sustainability
exactly.
is a big goal for us. And it's tough being a farmer, and especially as you mentioned, we have unique challenges here. One of the programs we're going to see today is Go Farms, which is a certification program for farmers to help them get some the actual tools that they need to succeed. Farming and USDA, again, helps fund that program.
All right, well, thank you guys again so very much, Senator.
Aloha.
Hirono.
Thank you so much,
Krista,
for joining us this morning. All right, still ahead, a recap of the day's top morning headlines. Time now, 6:48. We will be right back after the break.